$1,000 that you had on your two credit cards.
Correct.
$20,000 cash down.
Correct.
On a $331,000 bid.
Yes, very good. And you have to pay for the car, gas, maintenance, all that. But still, that was good. Even you said that was great.
Within about a year, Mohammed was medallion had appreciated $100,000, and remarkably, the value kept rising.
And lucky me, I was able to buy a house here in the Bronx, a three-family house. So it was good. And then moving forward, the medallion value was going up. In 2013, the city auctioned medallion at $1,250,000.
You heard correctly. 7 years ago, in theory, on paper, Mohammed Waliyu was a millionaire.
The only reason that it was worth over $1 million was that there was some unknown immigrant who could be taking advantage of to pay that amount. And not be able to even pay that amount, but be trapped in a loan that would shackle them in debt for the rest of their lives.
Brian Rosenthal, a reporter for the New York Times, won a Pulitzer Prize for his series exposing the taxi medallion scam.
It was the city which sold the medallions, the brokers who collected commissions, and the bankers who wrote the loans and sold some of them for profit. And what we found in our reporting was that the value of the medallion went from $200,000 to over $1 million when the revenue that the cap was putting in did not change at all.
I've been investigating.
As Brian explained in the New York Times documentary series, The Weekly, those medallions were moneymakers, just not for the drivers.
Eventually, you realize that this wasn't by accident. Many insiders knew that the whole thing was a house of cards. The loans were never stable, they were never sustainable, and they were always going to be a burden that was unpayable after this bubble popped. And that's what happened.
My name is Mohammed Waliyu.
Marshall.
That perhaps they had not before, and we're beginning to have a discussion, but there's no doubt that we've been talking past one another. I think that lots of people did not believe the extent of the problem.
Offer right now.
And that is that when you look at your skin, it looks good, it makes you feel good inside. You're skeptical about trying great race. I'm going to tell you from the bottom of my heart, your confidence is everything at this age. Where what's the point seems to be a lot of women's mantra after 50. I want to tell you this, it'll change the way you feel. Great race does make a difference.
Imagine seeing visibly smoother, firmer, younger looking skin on your body.
Oh, that was in Zoom. Stuff to wrap my leg with, so it's my storage unit. I'm gonna leave it like this. So I don't know if it's bleeding or not.
system for dry, creepy skin.